Hi guys, it's Elle. I hope you're all doing good. So I'm 50 days sober. Yeah, I got me. Woo-hoo. Cut my finger a little bit, so it's a little bit sore and it wouldn't stop bleeding, but I'm good. Sobriety's really helped me. Just taking my meds, feeling better every day. Most of my week I've been spending with my family because I have an aunt who's busy dying. She's got leukemia and she's on her last, so most of my time's been really just trying to be supportive with my family, which is really difficult, especially when you're going through your own stuff too. But I am fortunate to have, family support and whatnot, and settling into my new place a little bit more, which is really helping, and loving my purple hair. Just going on. As I say, every day gets easier. I still have good days and I still have bad days. But every day seems to get a little bit better. So, yeah. I went to the optometrist today. I got my specs redone. It's really nice. Spent some time with my little sister. She's such a cutie patootie, but so cheeky. And then we just visited my aunt again, but my weeks mostly consisted out of hospitals and whatnot, and then I also went to go see my friend Dive. Hi Dive, hi Dive. I really like Dive, he's a sweetheart. So misunderstood, just an amazing soul. His mom calls him Peter Pan, he's frolicking in the garden like a freak. His mom's like, "There goes Peter Pan." I've been chatting to my friends from treatment a bit more. I haven't seen them again, but we still chat all the time. And I got this great, really nice messages from my granny, and I spoke to my sisters who I live far away. So yeah, I'm really excited to just get back to work. I might have got a job at one of the local art galleries. It's just a part-time job, but it's great because then I can learn to really want to get into bronzes, learn how to manufacture and sculpt and stuff. And really, really excited for that. Really, really excited. So I've had a stressful week, but a good week. Trying to sort my stuff out, unpack my room, which is unpack my stuff, which has been taking ages and ages. I'm too much of a perfectionist, and I just keep moving things around and like repacking and unpacking boxes, and it's really tough. I'm just like my own worst enemy, but yeah. My room's a bit small and I didn't really have any space to work, so it's been hard to just can't focus on getting some of my art produced, and because my life is still chaos and more family drama. Drama, 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 drama. But I think the drama never goes away. I think when you have bipolar like I do, your life is always filled with drama. But my dad once said to me, "You have this, you have these two sides to you, and one is this beautiful, graceful woman, and the other one is a fucking maniac." And I was like, "Thanks." But what I've learned is, as long as you point your maniac in the right direction, you will be successful, and I know that I will be successful. And I've been fortunate to meet a lot of our local famous artists in my life and just like touch base with them. And I'm, you know, because I've moved to a different suburb, I don't really know anyone here. So I was fortunate enough to meet someone who is quite famous and quite a big, you know, big name in the art industry in our country, and especially in my province. And I actually met her at the hospital whilst visiting my aunt. She's a very good family friend. So she judges many art competitions and stuff like that. So it's really cool that I got to connect with her, and just I've been showing my art to a lot of people and people are really into it. So I'm really keen on getting some stuff manufactured and, you know, just getting my career going. I worked so hard on my internship, and so, yeah, still getting used to all the medication, upping my dosages, and, you know, but just taking it day by day, trying not to judge myself, trying not to judge others, trying to be good, or be good at it. Don't be good at it, yeah. Cock salad. But, yeah, so always remember when you are feeling alone and you do feel suicidal, and if you're not coping with your depression or your bipolar or your schizophrenia or just life, adulting, then get yourself into a treatment center, ask for help, you know. There are many facilities out there that can help you, and treatment works, you know, even more than the meds work, you know, just treatment works, just going to treatment, so just remember that you're not alone. And I think what a lot of people don't understand about being suicidal is that you really don't want to die, you just want the pain to end. And this is true, you know, you feel like a burden on everyone around you, but your suicide is even more of a burden on them than you realize. And it's something that I've realized, is that my suicide attempt was more of a burden on people around me and my loved ones than me trying to unburden them by committing suicide. So do not do it, please. Just ask for help, and or help yourself and get yourself into a treatment center. You know, call up a doctor, just Google a doctor, Google a closest psychiatrist, make a fucking appointment and just go. Just do it, doesn't matter how much it costs, it's worth it. It's so worth it, you know. So that's all I have to say for today. Keep loving yourself. Keep trying. Just keep being.